Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I'm going to show you how to export your track into multi-tracks. Some people call them stems. I'm going to show you how to make trackouts or wave trackouts. So what are trackouts? Trackouts basically allow you to separate each sound in your beat or your song and export it as an individual waveform. This way, if people just want the bass or they just want your vocal or they just want the drums, they can separate each sound and do whatever they want with it. So in this track, we have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, about 9 different things going on. Now the key here is that when you're making the beat, you need to make sure that you're accounting for each sound by sending it to the mixer. Different DAWs come with different routing scenarios. By default, you know, in Ableton Live, it gets routed to the mixer channel by automatically. In FL Studio, you have to route it manually. So other DAWs like Pro Tools, it gets routed automatically. Logic Pro, I believe, gets routed automatically. Studio One, the same. But FL Studio is a little bit different. So what does that mean? That means that by default, if I just load up a sound, it just goes to what's called the master. Okay, the master is just like the final thing, so to speak.
Busy.
So by default, whenever you see this number in FL Studio specifically, it should look like this. A little dash dash. In your channel rack, if you ever see a little dash dash, that means that that sound is going to the master track, which means everything combined. That's what the master is, everything combined in this case. Technically, it's a mix bus or master fader, some people would call it. So how do we separate stuff? So the first thing is I want to show you how to think when you're making the beat. So this is, you know, you probably thought it was just a 3-step video, which it is, but you have to understand what you're doing because you're going to mess yourself up later. So what you want to do is account for everything. Now, when you're making a beat, sometimes you want to add the same effects or the same processing as something else. So just because you have two separate sounds doesn't mean you always want them to go to a separate mixer channel, okay? So that's probably more advanced. So the first thing you need to do in FL, open your channel rack, highlight all your sounds, okay, and hit Control L. And what this will do is it will automatically route stuff to the mixer and it will name it for you. Now, the problem is if you don't rename this stuff and you just export it as is, the person getting it is like, what's Omnisphere? What's Omnisphere 2? What's Omnisphere 3? They don't know what these elements are. So you actually have to go in and rename them. Because when you export, FL Studio uses the name on the mixer channel to identify the wave file. So for example, if we go here, this is a loop section. It's a good habit to start isolating sounds and renaming the mixer. The only case where I would recommend not renaming something is like if you're using a sample. That way people can know the exact sample you're using and they don't have to guess, okay? And also if anything has BPM information on it or if it's a loop, like this one's called Got In My Head 103 BPM F sharp. So I'm gonna leave that there. And I don't think we even, oh yeah, that's the vocal. Actually, in this case, it's just a vocal chop, it's not a loop. So we're gonna call this vocal chop. Okay, so you right click, you hit rename, or you could right click, hit, I think R, let you do it. Yeah, right click, hit R, and then rename it. So in the channel rack, it shows you the number associated with the sound. So to see this, you hit Alt plus M in FL Studio. So for example, if I'm like, okay, what's routed to mixer channel 1? I can't find the sound. I would go to my channel rack and I would look for the number 1 and I say, okay, what's in number 1 slot is a sampler. It's nothing here. It's blank. So I can actually right click and delete that. Now what I have to do is go to the mixer, right click, hit E to reset the channel and hit okay. Because if anything is renamed in FL Studio or if anything is blindly routed to a mixer insert or mixer channel, it will actually print blank. So if that was like a sample that I forgot I muted, or it was named like, you know, some other name and there's nothing playing, it will print out as a WAV file, but it will be completely blank. And so you'll be delivering your track to somebody and they'll be like, was there supposed to be a sound here? Like, why is it blank? So you don't want to confuse people is my point. So you want to reset that by just hit right click, hit E to reset, hit enter. And then what a good habit is get it out the way. So I hit Alt right to move it out of the way. Just somewhere distant. Okay, also keep in mind if you have any active inputs, okay, or anything with a plugin on it, you wanna just reset these so it doesn't track those out. Okay, so now we're on the second sound. vocal chop. Okay, we got the zap. We got clap. So stuff that's like basic, like clap, zap. Okay, we get that kick. This is hi-hat. Now, when it says omnisphere, we're like, what is omnisphere? That could be a synth. It could be a pad. We don't know what it is. Okay, so I'm going to right-click and rename this bass. You want to make it as easy as possible for people who buy your stuff or the people you're sending this to know what the heck is on that specific track. They shouldn't have to listen to it to know what's on it. Okay, now the next one is a sample. So in this case, I would rename this sample. And then, whoops. Okay, so just go all the way to the left. Now we name it sample and then song or something like that to let people know the sample song is called Abuse and master part one. We don't need the master, this part. We don't need that. You could just hit accept. Okay, it's probably better you put the artist name, the song name, and the potential BPM of that sample. So it's super easy. The next sound, let's find it. Okay, so I'm gonna call this popcorn synth. Yeah, popcorn synth. Now notice this, we don't wanna get deep into it, but this sound is routed to here, so we're hearing both of those even when I'm soloing. So if you need to solo, you can always right click this little dot and it will solo that sound. Now the last thing we need to account for are these two at the end. Okay, so this is Omnisphere 3, but what is it? Okay, so I'm gonna call this synth 2. Okay, so now we have identified every single thing. It's probably also better you just rename the hi-hat, like the actual just hi-hat, instead of like the full name. Because this is another thing, when you're sending out stuff, it will put the name of the sound as the automatic mixer name. So if you don't want people to know what the exact kick drum you use or the exact whatever, you have to rename it or else they'll know the exact name. Okay. And I'll show you how to export all this stuff as separate waves, and then I'll show you how to do stems, and then we'll wrap this video up. I know it's a lot of information, but you have to understand this or else you're gonna be messing this up forever. Okay. So the next thing here is a vocal tag by Nicole Nix. So I'm going to call this vocal tag, and okay, so now everything is labeled. Okay, we got the vocal chop, the zap, the clap, the kick, the hi-hat, bass, sample, the popcorn synths, and then the vocal tag. Okay, so now that everything is accounted for in this song, I need to export these as wave, and I'll show you again how to do stems in a second for more advanced. So the difference between multi-track and stems is that stems is like exporting groups of sounds. Multi-tracks is going through each individual track and exporting that. You could have 100 tracks, you're exporting every single track. Whereas stems are, okay, you have 100 tracks, but you only want the percussion. Okay, you don't want to have 100, like 20 tracks of just different percussion. You just want one thing of all the percussion. And that's what stems are for, they're like groups. But before we get to stems, let's export this. So you go to File, Export, Wave. And if you're giving somebody a multi-track output, it's usually wave. Rarely do you do anything else. So the first thing I want to do is just call this, make a folder called Wave Export. And then you want to name the file the name of the song. So in this case, it's song name, BPM, and key. If you don't know what the key is or the BPM, you got to study up on what that means. The key of the song and the BPM. So the BPM is the number up here and next to your metronome. That's the BPM of the song, the rhythm, how fast it's going. The key is what musical scale that we're in. So that requires a little teaching that I don't have time for just now. So it's song name, BPM, key. Now, if you have an artist on here and you're tracking out an artist for like a mixing engineer, you would do artist, the song name, BPM, and then the key. Okay, so that all the information is in the individual wave file. So then you hit save. Right now I'm not going to do it here because it's going to waste space, but you go to full song. Okay, you want to cut remainder. A lot of people make the mistake and they leave the remainder. All the remainder does is if you have any reverb tails or like effects that kind of drag on after the song is done, it will keep those. Rarely do you ever need that. Okay, so cut remainder, wave file. You can also do MP3 as well, but again, you don't need MP3 of each individual sound. You only need an MP3 of the final full sound. So we can do that second. But anyway, go to Wave. 16-bit is fine. If you want to maintain like the different distortion, like if you're distorting and you want to retain the same wave information, go to 32-bit. If you don't need that information, just go to 16-bit. Stereo is fine. Resampling, I have mine at 32-point. Sync, high quality, disable maximum poly, polyphony. And here's the key that you have to turn on. It's called split mixer tracks. So this will take each individual sound and export it individually as its own file. So we're going to make sure that's on and hit start. So again, I'm not going to do it because it's going to take up time. But once you hit start, actually, let's, how long will this take? I don't know. Actually, let me think if I can show you another folder. So hit start and it will go. Okay, so I think I have another folder where I've already tracked stuff out. So let's go find it. Let's do this. And let's look for a tracked out session. Here we go, multi-tracks. So your file should look like this. When you're done exporting, it should look like this. Now, the one file that is kind of unnecessary is called the current file if you're exporting from FL Studio. So whenever you see something, something, something current, you could just delete that. It's just, it's basically a copy of the entire track. You could just move that to the trash. Now you see, I didn't do a good job naming my mixer channels here because this is just called Insert 16. And we're like, what is an Insert 16? What's a Booth Mic 3? These are not, I'm not telling people what it is. So you wanna be really careful when you're naming stuff so people understand what it is. So the master is the full track. This is the master fader. Okay, so that's the thing that is the final kind of everything. And then everything else is split up into its individual sound. Okay, so that's how it will look. And I recommend not only exporting the multi-tracks, I recommend copying this. So just copy your master wave, go to like a parent folder, and just paste your master wave here. So this is what I have right here. And this is a quick way for people to preview the song without going into the multi-tracks. Okay, so that's why I did it that way. Also, you can export MP3 if people want to just have the MP3 version. You could just go to Export MP3, and we'll click on that same folder. Hit Save. Again, I forgot to do one thing. Let me not teach you bad habits. Let's go to Export MP3, pick your folder of choice, and again, it's artist name, song name, BPM, and then the key. Okay, and hit save. Okay, my audio kind of tripped for a second. So what we don't need is to split mixer tracks. We can turn that off because again, the point of this MP3 is just to compile everything into one file. We don't need individual MP3s of every single sound. It's pointless. Keep in mind, MP3s add a small pause to the beginning of every song, so just keep that in mind. It's a small little blank pause. So if you go to mode, full song, and again, cut the remainder, we don't need the remainder, and turn off split mixer tracks, hit start, and it will leave you with just a single MP3 file. And I think it gave you options for quality, so let me, I forgot to mention that. Let me see where it is. So again, artist name, song name, BPM, and the key. Okay, let's see. There might be more information we need here. So here it is right here. It's looking for the slider. So it's asking us for the MP3 bitrate. CD quality is 320. Listenable quality is like 192. But I've seen platforms go all the way down to 128. So I mean, I think AAC or whatever, the Apple thing is 128. 192 is like, you know, online quality. 320 is like CD quality. So you can choose if you want to save space. You can go all the way down to 128. It just takes more or less space. Okay, that's what that's for. Okay, and let's find our folder. So let me show you one last thing, which is how to make stems. Okay, so stems are different. So in FL Studio, you have to understand how to do this or else you'll mess it up.
Busy.
So let's say you want your drums on a new track by themselves. So let's open up on the mixer channel, a new channel called drums. So what we're gonna do is compile all these sounds by hitting Control, left click, highlight all your sounds that are the drum category, and then right click this up arrow, and then route them directly to this track. So now when my drums play, they will all compile onto this one channel. Now when I export as a wave, they'll all be individually accounted for. However, we'll have an additional track called drums. So if the person just wants the stems, we can kind of just send them the drums file folder. Yeah, file, excuse me.
Busy.
Okay, so the bass and the synths we could separate. Let's call it like instruments. Now your basic stems are gonna be drums, instruments, bass, vocals. So it's four main categories of sound. Drums, instruments, vocals, and bass. So in this case, the bass is only one element and the vocals aren't on this track. So we only have two things to account for, the drums and the instruments.
Busy.
And so we're gonna take these things and even include this one over here and then right click, route to this track only. So now the instruments and the drums are going to be separated. So when you export as a wave, you'll have all the files just like we did before. It'll say vocals, zap, clap, blah, 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 blah. But the only thing you would send to that person is the, let's open this up again. The only thing you would send to that person is, where's our screen? Is the track that you want. So for example, let me see, do I have another folder in here? Where'd I put my stuff? I have a lot of folders. So multi, where is it at? I should have one called We Love, but I don't know where I put the folder. But anyway, the point is, again, you wouldn't send all the files, you would just send just the drums, just the reverb, just the, you know, bass. You wouldn't send every single sound. So that's if somebody asks for stems, okay? So that's how you group the sounds and then you would copy and paste them into a folder, right? So that is how we do it. And I wanna thank you for hopping in with me. I know it's a longer video than you expected, but this is the reality of exporting from FL Studio. It's not just this linear thing. You have to make sure all these steps are accounted for, like routing to the mixer, naming stuff in the mixer, exporting and splitting the tracks. If you want stems, you have to rename stuff, group them, and then export as separate tracks. So all this stuff ties together. And I know that was a lot, but that's, you know, if you're trying to get your beat business together, that's what you have to do. So after every beat, you know, I would recommend just exporting everything as wave just to be safe in the case that you can't load up your project anymore. I would also recommend if you're an FL Studio user, go to File, Export, Zipped Loop Package. This way, again, in the case that your project doesn't load or whatever, you have a backup. Copy of it with a zip loop package. So in a big folder, you'd have your FL Studio project file, you'd have the multi tracks, you'd have the exported final tracks, the MP3 and the wave, and what else would you need? And just a folder of just the sounds you used in the track, which will be in the zip loop package. So, and maybe a little notepad of any other information. So that's for every beat so that you can stay organized and, you know, worst case scenario, you can upload it to, you know, your cloud service and download it in the case that you have to move computers or do whatever. So I know that was a lot, but thank you for watching. It's Game from BusyWorksBeats.com.